At the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, we work through partnerships, collaborating on projects that are meant to satisfy particular needs, whether that be building a bridge, harbor dredging, beach replenishment, or the improvement of water quality. The Water Resources Reform and Development Act has called for action to improve water quality of the Chesapeake Bay and surrounding waterways. The Lynnhaven River Basin Ecosystem Restoration Project is part of a joint effort to ensure the health of these local tributaries where people like you and me frequently engage in recreational and commercial activities such as crabbing, fishing, boating, and kayaking. The bottom line purpose of this ecosystem restoration project is to improve the water quality and increase wildlife diversity through restoration of hard reefs, wetlands, and submerged aquatic vegetation. Initially, we had met with stakeholders and partners in a design charrette to come up with a design that adequately helps us meet our project goals. Once we have a design in hand, it gets us through a series of public meetings and quality control reviews to ensure it will satisfy Virginia Marine Resource Commission permit requirements. VMRC posted our application online to solicit feedback during the public commenting period of the design process. Additionally, aside from ensuring we satisfied permit requirements, our office also decided to participate in a face-to-face engagement with the members and leaders of the Broad Bay Civic League in order to inform them of our intent, provide them details of the design, and address any concerns that they had. These inputs were subsequently the motivation for multiple changes in the design over time. Some of the concerns included the loss of recreational value of the area and questions regarding safety as it pertains to water depth, substrate material, and project distance from private docks. Other concerns pertain to the fear that the area would be used for oyster harvesting. Ultimately, our design is focused on incorporating as much public input as possible while still achieving our project goals. Currently, we are still making all possible attempts to ensure that all feedback is taken into consideration and addressed. Up to date, all documented concerns have been addressed either through verbal communication of the project details, changes in the project design, or during site visits with the Civic League leadership.
There's a little bit of scar tissue from those other projects, you know, not to characterize too bluntly, but oversight and accountability and holding to standards the things that the Army Corps is known for, right? That's going to be an important part of this, to be able to convince folks that I got it and I feel good about it, as opposed to the ideas of using substandard materials.
During the site visit on October 25th, we toured the proposed reef site and used the onboard underwater survey equipment to show actual water depths as we explained the project dimensions and other technical details.
We were happy to communicate that, over three different design iterations,
we had completely changed the reef orientation to accommodate the preference to fish with the tidal current. This also led us to increase the spacing between the reef stripes to the same end. We increased the distance between the site boundary and private docks to allow more space for maneuvering and access. We reduced the overall height of the reef structure to ensure confidence in the fact that it will remain completely submerged underwater, and we changed the type of reef substrate
to a more environmentally friendly material.
Those aboard the vessel with us may have not noticed that we were also in the vicinity of an existing reef structure that we constructed back in 2008. Since completion of that project, residents have been safely enjoying their recreational activities on the water in that area. Since this reef is also completely submerged, it naturally doesn't detract from the homeowner's view of the water. So far, our engagements with the public have contributed to the successful progression of our project design. As much as we look forward to the successful completion of this project to satisfy the requirements of the Water Resources Reform and Development Act, we also continue to welcome valuable and constructive feedback from our local residents who have improved and shaped our design. This project is a long one, and your voice has actually had an impact thus far. The benefits of these restorations are gradual and will be most evident in the many years to come. Through collaboration to improve water quality and wildlife habitat, we ensure that our community and future generations can continue to enjoy outdoor recreational activities and our local waterways now and in the future.